We're finally here, Caleb. City of David.
This is the biggest place I've ever seen. I wish Mother could see this.
When your baby brother is old enough to travel, we will all come to Jerusalem to celebrate the Passover together. But you are going to school soon. It's important for me to show you the city of our fathers.
I think Jerusalem must be the center of the whole world, Abba.
It is the center of our world. Much, much more. Come on.
Thank you.
Remember, Caleb, we bought this lamb for a very special reason.
I know, Abba. He's very special. I promise to take real good care of him. I've even thought of a name for him.
No, son. You cannot name him. He is not a pet. He is our Passover lamb. Do you remember what that means?
I remember, Father. The Hebrews were slaves in Egypt for a long time. God sent Moses to ask Pharaoh to let them go, but even after all the plagues, he would not. And so God spoke to Moses and told every Hebrew family to kill a spotless lamb and put its blood on their doorposts.
Why did he tell them to do this?
Because at midnight, God himself passed over the land.
And in every home not covered by the blood of a lamb?
The firstborn son died. That would be me, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would. The lamb became their substitute. It died, so they would live.
But that was in Egypt. Why do we still kill the lambs now?
God told us to do this every year at this time, to remember his deliverance, to remember that God has always provided a way for his people. And when we obey God, we show our faith and love for him. Look up there, Caleb. Centuries ago, on that spot where the temple now stands, a man came to make a sacrifice to the Lord.
Abraham?
God said, Abraham, take your son, your only son Isaac, whom you love. Go to the mountain I will show you and offer him up to me as a sacrifice. See, God was testing Abraham's faith.
All of these years, I've waited and prayed for this child I see. Can you tell me somehow what to say to him now, as he looks up at me?
Here is the fire we've brought all this way, but I don't understand. Father, where is the lamb we are to offer today?
God will provide. God will provide the lamb. It is time to obey, though we don't understand. God will provide the lamb.
Abraham. Abraham.
Yes. Yes, I'm here.
Do not lay your hand on the boy. Now I know that you honor God because you have not kept your son, your only son, from me.
Look. Look, Isaac. There's a ram caught in the thicket. Isaac. Our sacrifice. God will provide the lamb. God will provide the lamb. It is time to obey, though we don't understand. God will provide the lamb.
It is time to obey, though we don't understand. your pendant?
It is! It was given to me by Procula. I'm her handmaiden.
You tried to rob Procula's servant? Procula is the wife of
Pontius Pilate, governor of Judea. My husband will hear of this insult. Centurion, I trust this garbage gets the punishment he deserves.
You may rest assured, his punishment will be quick and severe.
I believe you just earned yourself a death sentence.
It's probably the first honest thing he's ever earned.
Wait! Wait just a minute. This man looks familiar. Well, well, well. Do you know who we've just caught? This is Barabbas, one of the most wanted men in the Roman Empire. Guilty of robbery, causing riots, and murder.
We'll probably get a big fat bonus for bringing you in.
Well, let's get him to jail before he starts another riot. Come on, Barabbas.
And as for the rest of you, get back to your business peacefully, unless you care to join him.
Romans, bah! They try harder every day to crush us.
Here we are preparing for another Passover. But you know, it's no different today than it was under Egyptian slavery.
Surely God will send the Messiah soon to free us.
Those prophecies are centuries old. Maybe God has forgotten about us.
No, God would never abandon his people. He saved us then, and he will save us now.
For so many years we have waited, looking forward with hope to the day when God sends to us the Messiah to take this oppression away. The centuries ring with the promise
of the one who will set us free.
So God will honor his promise again.
Your Honor, permission to deliver matters of judgment.
Yes, what is it?
These papers require your seal.
All right, supply requests, messages. What's this?
Court papers authorizing punishment for the recently captured Barabbas.
Good. We've been after that one for a long time. Order his crucifixion to be carried out at week's end. He can join the other two condemned men downstairs.
Yes, sir. Oh, there's just one more thing, Your Honor. The High Priest has requested another audience with you. He's waiting downstairs.
Caiaphas again? My head aches from his constant whining. Tell him request denied.
Yes, sir.
What? He has refused to see me for the third time this week. You can tell Pilate I will get his attention. He underestimates my authority.
I'm afraid the only authority Pilate recognizes is Rome's.
You're right, Nicodemus. A misconception we'll have to correct. How do you think we should proceed, Joseph?
By taking care of the problems at hand. The Romans look to you to keep order among the Jews this week. But the money changers are gouging the people. The sellers are charging exorbitant prices.
Those are not religious matters. The peasant squabbles in the marketplace do not concern me. Well, do you have a report for me?
The people are saying that Jesus may be coming here for Passover to set up his kingdom.
The newest story is that he raised a dead man to life who'd been in the grave 4 days.
The people. This Jesus is all they talk about. Even one Roman captain claims Jesus healed his slave.
Enough already. Don't you have any good news? We are teachers of the law, educated men. You know, this Jesus isn't the first Messiah to come along, and he won't be the last.
Oh, no, but he's different than the others. I mean, he quotes the scriptures perfectly.
It's true that we've never heard teachings like this before.
Not to mention the miracles he does.
Does he really? Do miracles? Or are all these just fabricated stories and mass hysteria? I suggest you get to the bottom of this quickly. And I don't care how you do it.
Joseph! You've known about Jesus for some time now, haven't you?
I've known him almost 3 years. You know, the first time I saw Jesus was by the Jordan River. I'd been sent there to investigate a desert prophet named John the Baptist.
I am one voice crying in the wilderness, shouting at the emptiness of the world, singing one song of hope to those who've gone astray. Calling out, preparing the way of the Lord. I speak one truth, salvation for the weary soul. Repent and you will be made whole. Once again, a flame that pierces deep in the hearts of all men.
And every heart shall be filled, and every mountain be made bold. The rugged strains, the rough places plain, as all creation sees the salvation of God.
Are you the Christ?
No, I'm not the Christ. I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness. Make straight the way of the Lord. There stands one among you whom you do not know. And I tell you this, I am not worthy to unlace his sandals. I baptize you with water. He will baptize you in the Holy Spirit. There will
I have come to be baptized by you, John.
But why do you come to me? I should be baptized by you.
No. For now, this is how it should be. In obedience to the Father.
This is my son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased.
Yes, it is, but we better hurry or we're gonna be late. No, everyone in the village is gonna be there. I hope we have enough food.
Come on, wedding will start any minute.
You know, I even heard that Jesus of Nazareth is gonna be there.
If we don't want to be dismissed, we'd better be there. Now hurry.
Blessed art thou, O Lord, our God, King of the universe, Creator of the fruit of the vine. Blessed art thou, O Lord, our God.
Blessed art thou, O Lord, our God,
Creator of the universe. Gladden their hearts, make them as one, give them a river of joy.
Let the oil of gladness run into the cup and overflow.
Mother.
I am so glad you're here. I understand they've just run out of wine.
Mother, why do you involve me? My time has not yet come.
Servant, whatever he says to you, do it.
Servants, please, fill the jars with water. Now draw some out and take it to the master of the banquet.
My, this is good. Where did this wine come from? Excellent. My son, it is customary to serve the good wine first and to save the cheaper wine for later. But you, you have saved the best for last. Let the celebration continue.
We're so close now. Tomorrow, you will see your first sunrise. There is a man here who has healing in his hands. He's a carpenter from Nazareth. People are calling him the Messiah, and he can help us. I just know that soon you will see the face of the one who loves you so much. I know it.
Heard so many things about this man from Galilee.
How he brings new words from God, speaks with all authority.
Some say that he's just
a man like you and me. But some say he does miracles
and says,
send us away!
Go!
She can't hear.
The Romans kept the trash off the streets.
That's no ordinary trash. That's Mary of Magdala.
Harlot.
Not only that, she has demons.
I am the light of the world. Any man who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
How long are you going to keep us waiting?
If you are the Messiah, just tell us plainly.
I have told you, but you refuse to believe me. I am the door for the sheep. Those who come in through me will be saved. My sheep know my voice and I know them. You see, they follow me. I give them eternal life and they will never be lost. No one can snatch them out of my hand. Let me ask you this. If a man owns 100 sheep and one of them wanders away, will he not leave the 99 that are safe on the hillside to go look for the one that is lost? What is your name?
My name is...
You don't belong in her. Leave her. Now. Mary. Mary, your Father in heaven is not willing that any of these little ones should be lost. The Son of Man has come to save that which was lost.
Could it be he sees my heart? Could it be that he knows me? But if he really knew my life, he wouldn't give the love he showed me. Yet looking in his eyes, I see he knows, yet loves me still. And in that love I find the strength to go and do his will.
forgiven every wrong I've ever done. He knew my past, and yet he loved me. He knew my sin, yet he forgave me. He knew my life, and yet he claimed me for his own.
You know, there are many accounts of Jesus' life and his teachings, and there are many opinions about his identity. But there remains one very undisputable fact. Jesus of Nazareth is no ordinary man.
There is much to see in Jerusalem, my son, but the center of our life is here at the temple. This is where we worship. The priests read the laws of Moses and the prophets. The choirs sing day and night.
And this is where we'll bring the lamb too, isn't it?
Yes, son. At the end of the week.
Abba, will we still have to kill the lamb if the Messiah comes?
Why do you ask such a thing, Caleb?
Since we got here, the people have been speaking of Jesus. I heard many of them say he's the Messiah, so it must be true.
Jesus is coming, the King is coming to Jerusalem. Everyone's running to see the Messiah. Come on, Jesus is coming, the King is coming.
Hosanna to the Son of David. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the coming King. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Son of David. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the coming King. Rejoice, ye daughters of Zion. Behold your coming King.
The situation with the Nazarene is becoming intolerable. We are losing control.
Did you see his entry into the city? The people are calling him king.
If this man is allowed to continue, we will have a riot on our hands.
And that will bring Pilate's wrath down on us all. He can take away our position and our nation.
Enough!
You know nothing. Do you not realize it is better that one man die for the people than for the entire nation to perish? And to that end, let me introduce to you an old friend of his and a new friend of ours. This is Judas Iscariot.
I know where he's staying, and I know where he goes to be alone. I could take you right to him.
Why would you help us? You're one of his followers.
Not really. You see, I've pretended to believe in this foolish kingdom of his for reasons of my own. But now the only thing I believe is that I can help you. That is, if you'll make it worth my while.
Name your price.
He's planning to spend the Passover feast with his disciples. I have to be there or he'll suspect that I'm up to something. But afterwards, yes, afterwards I could take you to
him. Your price, betrayer.
A bargain, O high priest. A mere 30 pieces of silver.
The price of a slave. Done.
Little children, I promise you this. Anyone who loves his life will lose it. But anyone who gives up his life for my sake will have eternal life. I am the good shepherd. You see, the good shepherd gives his life for his sheep. No man takes it away from me. I give it up willingly. Remember that the Son of Man has come not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a substitute for many. We must go. My hour has come.
Caleb, let's go. It's time for bed.
Can I stay with him just a few more minutes, Abba? Please?
You know,
just one last time?
No, tomorrow is Passover, son. We must take the lamb to the temple. He must die in our place.
Yes, Abba, I know.
Just a few more minutes, Caleb.
It's okay, boy. Please try to understand. You're very special. We need you. I know the will of the Father. I know that we must obey. But still,
we are the ones who have sinned.
The time has come. The kingdom of God is at hand. My Father has given me that kingdom, and now I give you the right to eat and drink at my table in that kingdom.
What a fool I've been. How could I be taken in by this talk of a kingdom that would never end? I believed his words and the promises I heard, but no more, no more will I pretend.
Take, eat. This is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me.
In remembrance of you, Lord, in remembrance of you, we'll never forget this sweet friendship we knew. We will
take, drink all of it. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you. Judas, what you are about to do, do quickly. I will only be with you a little longer. Then you will come and look for me, but you will not find me. So now I give you a new commandment. Love one another, even as I have loved you. In this way, people will know that you are my disciples.
Where are you going, Lord?
Where I am going, you cannot follow now, but you will follow later.
But why can't I follow you? Lord, I would die for you.
Die for me? Peter, before the rooster crows tomorrow morning, you will deny that you even know me 3 times.
No, never, Lord.
Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. I am going to prepare a place for you that where I am, you may be also. You know the way to the place where I'm going.
But Lord, we don't know where you're going. So how can we know the way?
Thomas, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. You see, I have told these things to you that you may have peace in me. In this world, you will have trouble, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. We must go. John. We have to go. Sit here while I pray. Peter, James, John. My soul is overwhelmed to the point of death. Please, watch and pray, lest you fall into temptation. Father, oh Father, the words you have given to me, I have given to them. Father, the glory you have shown to me, I have shown to them. That they may be as one, even as we are one. Father! Let this cup pass from me, Father. If there's any other way, if there's any other way, let this cup pass from me, Father. Abba! Everything, Father, not my will, not my will, but thy will be done. Could you not stop and pray for 1 hour? Enough! Rise up. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Here is my betrayer. You betray the Son of Man with a kiss. Who is it that you are looking for?
I am Malchus, servant to Caiaphas. Are you Jesus of Nazareth?
I am. If you're looking for me, then let these men go.
No!
Peter!
Over here!
No more of this! Put your sword back in its place. For all who live by the sword die by the sword. Do you not think I could call on my father?
And he will at once send 12 legions of angels. But if I were to do that, how would the scriptures be fulfilled that say it must happen in this way? Every day I was with you in the temple courts, and you did not lay a hand on me. But now you come with swords and clubs to arrest me like a criminal? What the scriptures say must come to pass. Arrest him! Arrest them all!
What wrong has this man done? Are there any witnesses? What are the charges brought against this man?
He said he would destroy this temple made with hands.
And in 3 days he would build another. Do you have an answer? Are you the Christ?
I am.
Blasphemy! Blasphemy! No more witnesses! What is to be done with this man? For sentencing.
I know you. Oh, yes. You were with Jesus of Galilee.
I don't know what you're talking about.
That's the man who was with Jesus of Nazareth.
No. Yes. I don't know that man.
You're one of Jesus' followers. I'm positive of it. Your answer gives you away.
You don't know what you're talking about. You're all crazy. I do not know that man. I don't know him.
Of what do you accuse this man?
He claims to be the Christ, and he spreads this lie from here to Galilee.
This prisoner is from Galilee?
He is, most noble Pilate.
Galilee is not my jurisdiction. Let Herod decide his fate.
Welcome, Jesus! I've waited such a long time to meet you. It's so good to have you as a guest in our home. Although, after seeing you, you are hardly what I expected. Can it be that this is a problem which Caiaphas and Pilate cannot come with? Oh, Jesus! I am told that you can perform miracles. Let's see, that you can heal the sick. Oh, yes, and that you can raise people from the dead. Boom. You must do something to entertain us. Go ahead. Gather around, everyone. Jesus is going to do magic. Just whatever pops into your head. Well, just as I expected, suppose there won't be any miracles today. Guards, this man brings me no pleasure. I am not amused. Clean him up and give him some food and send him on about his way. But Jesus, please come back. Before you go, I'm just a little confused. If you're not busy,
We need to clear up this little rumor about your being the king of the Jews. It is me, Herod. I am the king of the Jews. Do you realize that you can make life so much easier on yourself and for all of us concerned if you just take back this little rumor? Do you realize that Caiaphas wants you dead? And what Caiaphas wants, he usually gets. But maybe not this time. I have a plan. Let's suppose that you go back and tell the people this idea about your being the Messiah is just a mistake, and you leave Jerusalem once and for all, and I will see to it that Caiaphas leaves you alone. What do you say? Have we an agreement? Speak up, man. I said, have we an agreement? You mock me with your silence. Very well, guards. Take him back to Pilate and tell him this is what Herod thinks of his king of the Jews. Indeed, this man is the king of the fools.
Why are you bringing this man back to me? I have found no fault in him. The people demand his death. What is your response to them?
Punish him yourselves.
We would, most noble Pilate.
But it's against your laws for us to put a man to death!
Are you the king of the Jews?
You have rightly said that I am a king.
Still I find no fault in him!
Pilate, I must speak to you. I know it is not my place to interfere with your judgments, but this time I must. I had a terrible dream, and I believe it is a warning. Do not punish Jesus, I beg you. If you do, something terrible will happen. I know it.
But have you seen this crowd? They leave me no choice.
Is it not your custom to release the prisoner to them during their feast?
Yes, but what?
Have the guards go to the jail and bring out the vilest, most disgusting piece of filth they can find. Then offer the people their choice, him or Jesus.
Of course. Given that choice, they'll surely choose Jesus over a condemned murderer. It's brilliant, my dear. Centurion, bring Barabbas up from the jail. People of Judea, I have made every effort over the years to work together with you for peace. Now, as you know, it is my custom each year to deliver one prisoner to you. This year, I give you a choice. Barabbas, guilty of insurrection, robbery, murder, or Jesus, in whom I have found no fault. Now, who would you have me release to you?
Barabbas!
But I find no fault in him! But what would you have me do with this Jesus? The blood of this man be on you. Centurion, prepare the papers for the release of Barabbas. And as for him, his blood be on your hands. Away with him! Let him be crucified!
A man of sorrows, acquainted with our greed. A man despised and rejected, surely we esteemed him not. Nothing to make us desire him,
forgive them, for they know not what they do.
I don't want your forgiveness, Jesus!
Look, Barabbas, you see that cross? We made that for you. That man is dying in your place. Jesus of Nazareth is your substitute.
Come down from the cross. If you can.
He saved others, but he cannot save himself.
If you're king of the Jews, then save yourself.
Aren't you the Christ? Save yourself and us.
Quiet thief. Don't you know who you're talking to? Jesus. Remember me when you come into your kingdom.
Truly I say, today, you will be with me in paradise.
Thank you.
this really was the Son of God.
Centurion, the high priests have been to see Pilate. They say that if the crucified remain on the trees at sunset, then all of Golgotha would be defiled.
Then make sure he's dead.
Joseph of Arimathea, Nicodemus, why do you come to me at this time of day?
Pilate, sir, I have come to request that the body of Jesus be released to me for burial in my tomb.
You, a member of the great Sanhedrin, you, a follower of Jesus Christ.
I have kept it secret until now because I feared them.
You realize, of course, that if I give his body to you, it will no longer be a secret.
Sir, we are prepared to accept the consequences.
Centurion! When Jesus is dead, give his body to this man.
Jesus is already dead.
Joseph, why have the guards been posted here?
The chief priest went to Pilate and reported what Jesus predicted before he died, that in 3 days he would rise. They fear the disciples will steal his body and then tell people he is risen.
No, Mary, we must leave. But Joanna,
We barely had time to prepare his body for burial.
I know, but it's almost time for the Sabbath to begin. Maybe we can come back tomorrow, but we must leave now. It's especially since it's Passover.
He can't be gone.
I know. I know.
It can't be over.
I know. We must leave. We must go.
Nicodemus, do you think it's over?
Joseph, Jesus told me something a long time ago. It said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not die, but have eternal life. I do believe that, Joseph. So no, I don't think it's over. I think it's just beginning.
Satan shouted with a triumph, and all the earth was still. 3 days and nights, those who loved him mourned the dead. Why didn't they remember what he said? I shall rise, I shall rise, in the power. Their shouts of jubilation quickly turned to shrieks of doom as the mighty Son of God arose again among the dead. And all creation shouted with his cry. I shall rise, I shall rise, and the power
someone. But will they believe me? Mary of Magdala. They'll think I'm hysterical or possessed again. Jesus would believe me. He would understand.
Woman, why are you crying?
Sir, if you have carried him away, please tell me where you have put him and I will go get him.
Mary.
Teacher.
Do not cling unto me, Mary, for I have not yet ascended unto my Father. But go to my disciples and tell them that I am returning to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God.
See my friends at home.
We have been here a long time, son. Over 40 days. But I had to stay. I had to find out everything I could about Jesus from anyone who knew him.
Do you believe he was the Son of God?
Not was, Caleb. Jesus is God's Son. I believe that he died on that cross for our sins. Many people have seen him alive these past weeks. Yes, Jesus is the Son of God.
Like my lamb.
What's the matter?
Jesus was God's lamb, wasn't he? He was the real substitute.
Yes, my son.
authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And surely I will be with you always, even until the very end of the age.
It could be today, it could be this very hour, when he comes in royal majesty, with glory and with power. Yes, he will come again, he'll come for you and me, and when the trumpet sounds, our waiting eyes will see. Jesus, as he calls us to come home, he will come.
It has well been said that if Jesus Christ is still in that tomb, nothing really matters. But if Jesus Christ came out of that tomb, nothing but that really matters. You see, the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ is the gospel. And that's the reason the Bible says in Romans 10 that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Would you pray a prayer like this? Lord Jesus, I do confess that you're Lord. I believe you're the Son of God. I believe you carried my sins to the cross and paid for them with your own blood. I believe that God raised you from the dead. And now by faith, like a child, right now, this moment, I pray, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive my sin. Save me, Lord Jesus. And Lord Jesus, because you are now my Savior, I will follow you all the days of my life. And Lord Jesus, because you are my Lord, I will never, ever, by your grace, never ever be ashamed of you. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Amen.
I, John, a fellow servant of the Lord, am writing this letter to you, exiled to the island of Patmos for preaching the word of God. I was worshiping on the Lord's day when from behind me I heard a loud voice, like a trumpet, saying, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end, who is, who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. When I turned to see who was speaking, I saw one who looked like Jesus. I fell at his feet as dead, but he laid a hand on me and said, don't be afraid. Write down what you see. Come, and I will show you what must happen in the future. Then I saw a vast crowd, too great to count, from all nations and languages, clothed in white. These are the ones who have washed their robes white in the blood of the Lamb. They stand before the throne of God and worship day and night, shouting, "Holy, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty. Blessing and glory and wisdom and honor and power and praise be to our God forever and forever." Then I saw heaven open, and there was a man who had eyes like flames of fire, wearing many crowns. He comes to judge the righteous, and all the armies of the heaven are clothed in fine linen, white and clean, followed him to make war. He wore a robe covered with blood, and he was called the Word of God. On the part of his robe that covered his thigh was written, "King of Kings and Lord of Lords."
Thank you. time, God has revealed Christ, the living Word, through His holy scriptures. In Genesis, He's the ram at Abraham's altar. In Exodus, He's the Passover lamb. In Leviticus, He's our high priest. In Numbers, He's the cloud by day and the pillar of fire by night. In Deuteronomy, He's our city of refuge. In Joshua, He's the scarlet thread out Rahab's window. In Judges, He is our judge. In Ruth, He's our kinsman redeemer. In 1 and 2 Samuel, He's our God of providence. In Kings and Chronicles, He's our reigning king. In Ezra, He's the restorer of our worship. In Nehemiah, He's the rebuilder of the brokenness. In Esther, He's the God of providence. In Job, He is my redeemer, whoever lives. In Psalms, He is my shepherd, and I shall not want. In Proverbs and Ecclesiastes, He is our wisdom. And in the Song of Solomon, He's the chiefest of 10,000. In Isaiah, He is the man of sorrows. In Jeremiah and Lamentations, He is our righteous judge. In Ezekiel, He is the Lord who is always there. In Daniel, He's the smiting stone. In Hosea, He's the God of redeeming love. In Joel, He's the hope of His people. In Amos, He's the righteous one. In Obadiah, He's the executor of justice. In Jonah, He is the one sent forth into the world by His Father. In Micah, He's the God of my salvation. In Nahum, He's the stronghold in the day of trouble. In Habakkuk, He's the restorer of our faith. In Zephaniah, He's the Lord mighty to save. In Haggai, He's the desire of all nations. In Zechariah, He's our wall of fire. And in Malachi, He's the refiner and purifier of all those who come to Him. In Matthew, He is Jesus Christ, our King. In Mark, He's the servant of the Lord. In Luke, He's the Son of Man that comes to seek and save all those that are lost. In John, He's the Son of God, the great I Am. In Acts, He is our ascended Savior. In Romans, He is our justification. In 1 Corinthians, He is our resurrected King. In 2 Corinthians, He is our treasure in earthen vessels. In Galatians, He's the bearer of our sins. In Ephesians, He's our chief cornerstone. In Philippians, He is the exalted one. In Colossians, He's the image of the invisible God. In 1 Thessalonians, He's our soon coming King. In 2 Thessalonians, He is the God of recompense. In 1 Timothy, He's the mediator between God and man. In 2 Timothy, He's the promise of life. In Titus, He's the God of mercy. In Philemon, He's the God who ever intercedes. In Hebrews, He's our ever-living intercessor. In James, He's the giver of grace. In 1 and 2 Peter, He is the chief shepherd. In 1, 2, and 3 John, He's our advocate with the Father. In Jude, He is the only wise God, our Savior. And in Revelations, He is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the ending, who was, who is, and is to come. Lift up your eyes, church, for your redemption draweth nigh. He is King of kings and Lord of lords.